Alright, you guys, here we are. We're in the Dragon Blaze. And I figured it would be a good time to show off my Hydras. Hydra! First, I guess I should go into my team so we can see the details of that. Because I ain't about keeping secrets around here. Now, let's see here. I'm going to be using Drunken Falcon, Ravengale, Leowin, Bloodwind, and then I'm going to be alternating the helper. I'm going to try to use Brightspark. I'm going to try to use Margaret, and I'm going to try to use Pharah. But I'm going to have to level her up a little bit beforehand. That'll be off camera. Let's start off with who I think is probably going to be one of the more favorable. Let's take a look at the gear. Okay. We've got the... her gear is like probably the worst out of the group. But we've got a 2 Deus Rag, 2 Dark, so I got the crit up a little bit. I've got some decent crit rate, some decent defense penetration, but that's about it for her. And we've got a Divine, because I just didn't have anything else to give her, with a... Everybody else, though, we're pretty decked out. We've got the crit rate setup going on here with Bloodwind. Crit and crit rate. You can see that he's got over 60% and over, almost 70% defense penetration. But we take a look at her. And she be packing some good shit. This good shit. We've got one that's pretty much designed for PvP, and then one for boss damage. But that's where most of her defense penetration comes from. But look at that crit. That's a nice crit. She's also over 50% crit rate. So that's good. Ravengale's got some good stuff too. Her, usually her setup is over 400% crit damage, but I don't know. I guess somebody else is wearing, it must be this one here. Somebody else must be wearing the one she usually wears. My suspect is my priest. And we've got Drunken Falcon. He's wearing the same setup. This is actually my warrior's gear. He's kind of borrowing it because he actually is new to my team. He doesn't have his own gear. Same for Margaret. She's borrowing stuff too. But let's take a look at my priest here. Yeah, here's Ravengale's usual weapon, but I wanted it so she can suck it. Decent shit all around. These belong to Bright Spark, but I'm borrowing them. Anyway, let's get this show on the road. Let's see what happens. Sadly enough, the robot is better at controlling than I am. So, think what you want about me there, but I can only do so much when I have to scroll this mouse across the screen to perform. So I'm just pretty much going to be the one bringing in my ally. At least the second time. I feel like this team setup is pretty good. Margaret's kind of random with what she does for me, because of the fact that she randomly brings in a deity. So sometimes it's better than others. Other times it's just kind of meh, you know? But we got hell of high damage. See how far they can get before she poofs out of existence the first time. Like 21. Yeah, 22. She'll be back later. I just gotta trust in my bot to heal up my guys as needed. I think the bot kind of slacks on the healing, but they're pretty good about hitting those skills up. See, because if I was controlling the priest right now, I'd be healing the priest, because she's got a little nick out of her, and I don't like that. But I find my interference to be more of a hinder than a help. At least on the blue stacks, it's a kind of a hindrance. We'll just see what it does. Now this, by far, is my best score out of the three world bosses. So don't expect anything better from me coming for the Golem or Sheree. It's just not something I can do. Especially Sheree. I just can't figure Sheree out. I've done what I think I need to do, but it's not working for me. I can't get past 42 million. Just can't do it. It's kind of embarrassing because one of my guild members, or one of the guild members, has a team that they just slap together randomly, and it does better in Sheree than my team that I meticulously picked. That's kind of irritating, to be honest. And with Golem, I just don't have enough defense penetration, because there's no way I can live through its later attacks, the rage mode. Now I'm wondering what's going to happen when I use Pharah, because that skill that raises everybody's attack, and the other one that reflects all the damage that the enemy does, that's probably going to do a lot of damage to the Hydra, considering it does so much damage to me. The issue is that, like Margaret, my Pharah isn't exactly the best right now. She's still not maxed out. Well, she's max, but that's it. Okay, we're gonna bring her back in the 90 million range. Okay. Now it's all up to them. Oh, come on, robot! What are you doing? Ah, you piece of crap! See? Now that's irritating. trust in the robot and it'll fail. Well, it looks like I'm not even gonna beat the score that I set earlier before I decided to record this. So, this is gonna be a sad one. Man, Izark, he's still hanging out, even though Ravengale's been gone for a long ass time. Way to go, Drunken Falcon, hanging in. Hanging in till the bitter end. Computer has failed me. I am disappointed. Okay, now we're going to switch the teams up. Alright, here's what we're using for Bright Spark. Kinda sad. She's got a little bit over there. And we're going to be taking her in. She doesn't get to get a lot of play lately. Ever since Margaret came out, Bright Spark's been kind of benched, which kind of sucks because I love her. And I miss using her, but I just can't justify it because there's no reason for me to bring her in. Here we go. We're going to try this out. Bright Spark. Come on, Bright Spark. Pull it out. Now, the downside of this is the Bright Spark doesn't bring in an extra ally, so that's a little bit lower damage. But I do think that her attacks on her own are probably better. And she does have the ability to stun the enemy quite nicely. It's a big help sometimes. It looks like she does about the same amount of damage as Margaret. She got up 1 million more before she got sent out. So she's in the same ballpark as Margaret, so I don't expect big things from her. But, I just wanted to give her a shot, because she just doesn't get any play lately. Up next we'll try Farah, so that'll be a little different. I've never used Farah in here before, so I don't know how it's going to go. I'm not even sure what I should be using for her. I'm just going to probably toss Black Aria's gear on her. Because she has no gear of her own. She was just made today out of one of my allies that I've had for a very, very long time. Dark Priest Porin. She's been sitting in my base for months, maybe half a year. And she's had +3 over max for that long. She's just been hanging out. Never used. Because once I got Black Aria, there was no going back. Now, if I could bind keys to my emulator here, I would set up a hotkey so that I could push the guidance and magnify myself so that I could heal manually, because it is a lot better to heal manually. The robot likes to slack off quite a bit when it comes to healing, and I don't appreciate that. See, like, if I was healing them, they wouldn't have those injuries right now. It's getting on my nerves. We're gonna try bringing her in at 90 million again. Just so we can see how it goes. Come on, you motherfucker, don't do this to me. Don't make me fucking bust out the heels myself. Freaking jerk. Stupid bot. It's a Riri! Okay, we got Bright Spark in now. Go at it, guys. Go at it. Fuck that shit up. Okay. Good. Over 100,000 or 100 million now. Love being over 100 million. Come on, keep it coming. Come on, you fucking asshole! Fucking bot! I swear to God. I swear. Why does the bot suck so bad when it comes to healing the party? Okay, fuck it. Just give up then, I guess. Okay. So we got the 110 million. That's a little bit better than the automatic. That's a little bit better than the automatic Margaret party, but not a whole lot. And certainly not better than the one that I did earlier. So now we're going to try out Farah, and that'll be the end of it. Alrighty, here we go. I got my little Farah leveled up with her stupid gazelle or whatever the fuck this thing is. Forest Guardian. Let's see how this goes. Again, I'm just gonna let the bot take care of things, even though it's not exactly the best. I'll take care of the point score later when I do it on my phone. Here we go. Hope this works out. She's just wearing Blackaria's gear, so she doesn't have anything of her own. See how this works. Now I know she's not going to be really contributing to the fight in a sense that she's not going to be really doing a lot of damage, but hopefully having her around keeps everybody alive for a little longer, and I really want to see what that reflect does. Things are going okay. Could be better, but right now the Hydra isn't actually pumping out any damage on me, so I guess that's a thing. It doesn't look like she's gonna be matching the other girls though at all. Close, but no cigar. She's out of there before she hits 20 million, so she didn't really score as high as the other ladies. However, the next time I summon her in, her reflect skill might actually pay off. Keep in mind, Farrah is new. I don't have anything on her. No card. She's just got Lekaria's gear, and that's about it. And the levels. That's all I can put into her right now. But she's okay. I'm not really raving about her right now. We'll see what she can do once this thing actually hits 90 million. I'm hoping that she'll really help because she is a good healer. And that's something that I haven't been using in any of my world bosses lately, except for Sharif. She's really going to help me out there because I only have one decent ally healer. So it'll let me use Heavenly Protection instead of using what's the other one? Noble Chivalry. Yeah. That way I can use my Paladin or my Warrior as the main, and they can make the team way more durable. And then I can have Falcon in there. I can have Lekaria and Farrah in there. And Ravengale, because she's pretty much good in every world boss. She's like an asset, really. Ravengale's awesome. For this particular function. Anything else, she's kind of meh. But in this area, she's pretty much an expert. Alright, let's get ready to bring in Farrah. Get my cursor on her. Everything's going okay so far. I'm starting to not like the looks of it though. With my healer not healing, I might have to bring her in earlier than I thought. Because it's taking a lot longer without that extra boost of damage. If the shit starts to hit the fan, I'm going to bring in Farrah earlier. Gross. Come on, you guys, don't give out on me. Now, the downside to Farrah is she doesn't have any resurrection techniques. Okay. Here we go. Let's see what she can do now. I want to see what this reflect does. I mean, she's okay. They're almost making it to the 100 million mark. Okay, good. Come on, don't even. Don't get... Oh. Ravengale, no! Okay, that's not good. That's not good at all. But things seem to be going well. Her heals are helping. Even though Ravengale's out of the picture. Okay, now Leowyn's out, so this is bad. This is real bad. What will we do here? Bloodwind is hanging in there pretty well. Okay. No, come on. Come on. Aww. Well, they scored marginally better than Bright Spark. Not much, though, really. 111 million. Not my best. So far, my best score, I'm pretty sure, is Bright Spark. She got to 118 million once. But the best I've done today was Margaret. Margaret got to 116 million, as we can see here. That's pretty much it. Well, thanks for watching.